Good morning, everyone. Now, before starting the new lesson, coordination compound, we all know that we are facing COVID-19. So there are certain guidelines for the COVID-19. The first one is wear mask properly. The second thing is wash your hand regularly with the help of soap and water for at least 20 seconds. And the main important thing is maintain the physical distancing, maintain the social distancing, and do not share the eatables and the water bottles with anybody else. Now come to the topic, that is coordination compound. So coordination compound are the backbone of modern inorganic and bioorganic chemistry. Coordination compounds are the, they are considered as a backbone. They are considered as a backbone of modern inorganic and bioorganic, inorganic and bioorganic chemistry, inorganic and inorganic and bio inorganic chemistry and the chemical industry. So this is a modern it is a very actually it is a type of a achievement in the field of the chemistry, that is the coordination compounds. So in the previous unit, because we have done the previous chapter of this one, so in the previous unit, that is the D and F block element, where we have studied about the properties of the transition element, lanthanoids, actinoids. So we have seen that there are complex compound transition metal form a large number of complex compound. Transition. So transition element or transition metal form large number of complex compound, and this is one of the important property of the transition metal, because they form the complexes, they form the complex compound. And in such complex compound, the metal atom are bonded to number of anions and neutral molecule, that is metal atoms are bound to a number of anions or neutral molecules, number of anions and neutral molecule. Now it is clear, that is anions means they contain the negative charge. The species which contain the negative charge, they are termed as the anions, and the neutral molecule means which do not possess any kind of a charge, that is known as the neutral molecule. So in modern terminology, such compounds are called coordination compound. Such complex compound are known as the coordination. Such compounds are called the coordination compounds. Earlier we call them as a complex compound, but now in the modern terminology, we term them as a coordination compound. So, the chemistry of the coordination compound is an important, it is very important and challenging area of modern inorganic chemistry, because we have the variety of the coordination compound, and such coordination compound has a variety of property. There they have the different kind of a structure. So, it's just a challenge in the modern inorganic chemistry. Earlier, the coordination compound are termed as a कॉम्प्लेक्स कंपाउंड. वाई दे कॉल द कॉम्प्लेक्स? बिकॉज देयर स्ट्रक्चर इज कॉम्प्लेक्स, बिकॉज दे आर कंपोज ऑफ द मेटल एटम, दे आर कंपोज ऑफ द एनायंस और द न्यूट्रल मॉलिक्यूल. बट नाउ इन द मॉडर्न एरा दे आर टर्म्ड एज अ कोऑर्डिनेशन कंपाउंड. सो द दे आर देयर केमिस्ट्री इज वेरी डिफरेंट एंड वेरी इट इज अ वेरी चैलेंजिंग एरिया इन द मॉडर्न इनऑर्गेनिक केमिस्ट्री. सो न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ केमिकल बॉन्डिंग एंड मॉलिक्यूलर स्ट्रक्चर हैव प्रोवाइड इनसाइट इन टू द फंक्शनिंग ऑफ द वाइटल कंपोनेंट ऑफ बायोलॉजिकल सिस्टम. Because in the in case of the coordination compound, we have already studied the type of the bonding, what type of a bonding is present in between the metal ion and the anion, or in between the metal atom or the neutral molecule. So they actually this one is the entire they have entirely different properties. The coordination compound have the entirely different properties. Now the chlorophyll, we have already studied. We know what is a chlorophyll. It is present in a plant. It is a plant pigment. It is present in the green leaves of the plant. We know about the hemoglobin. It is a red color pigment which is present inside the which is inside the human body, that is in the form of a blood, hemin. It contains the hemin. So the examples are, first is the chlorophyll, that is chlorophyll. Second is hemoglobin, chlorophyll, hemoglobin, and that is one. There is one vitamin, that is vitamin B12. They are the coordination compound. They are the coordination. They are the coordination compounds. They are the coordination compounds of magnesium. They are the coordination compound of magnesium. They are the coordination compound of magnesium. They are the coordination compound of iron. They are the coordination compound of cobalt. It means the chlorophyll, hemoglobin, and vitamin B12, they are considered as a coordination compound. When we studied the structure of the chlorophyll, hemoglobin, and the vitamin B12, then we can easily find out that how complex their structure is and how they become a coordination compound. And they are the coordination compounds of the magnesium. Magnesium is present in them. Iron is present in them, because we know that hemoglobin, the main source of hemoglobin, if we are talking about the level of the hemoglobin is increases or decreases inside the human body. So we are talking about the iron, the content of the iron pigment. If the hemoglobin is increased, so the iron is sufficient inside the blood. And if we say that the concentration of hemoglobin is decreases in our body, it means which pigment, that is which element, is in the lesser amount, that is the iron. So these three are the coordination compound of the magnesium, iron, and cobalt respectively. This one contain the magnesium, hemoglobin contain the iron, and B12 contain the cobalt. Here this one magnesium is present in the chlorophyll, the main pigment in the chlorophyll, the main element which is present in the chlorophyll, which this is called the magnesium. If we are talking about the hemoglobin, means which is responsible, that is the iron. And if we are talking about the vitamin B12, so we are talking about the element cobalt. So the now a variety of metallurgical process. Now here is a term, that is metallurgical, that is called metallurgical process. So a metallurgical process means, we all are familiar with the term metallurgy. This is the extraction, this is the technique of the extraction. When we extract any pure element or any pure metal from its ore, that term, then there we use the term metallurgy, the extraction of the metal from its ore. When we extract the pure metal from its ore, it is termed as a metallurgy. So the variety of metallurgical processes and industrial catalyst and analytical reagent involve the use of coordination compound. They involve in the uses of the coordination compound. And the coordination compound also find many application. They are very useful. They are very useful. So the coordination compound also find many application in, that is in electroplating, that is called electroplating, and in textile it is useful in the textile dyeing, that is the fabric industry where the dyeing process takes place, and coordination compound are also very useful in medicinal chemistry, because there are so many medicines where there is a formation of the coordination compound takes place. The preparation of the medicine is because of the coordination compound. Because of the coordination compound, that's why it is useful in the medical field. That is the medicinal chemistry, electroplating. We have used that coordination compound, and the textile industry and the dyeing industry. Now the next topic is Werner's theory of coordination compounds. Werner's theory of coordination compound. So in 1866 to 1919, Alfred Werner, a Swiss chemist, was the first to formulate his idea about the structure of coordination compound. So he gave the idea about the structure of coordination compounds. Structure of coordination compound. So for that, he prepared and characterized a large number of coordination compound and studied their physical and chemical behavior. Physical and chemical behavior by simple experimental techniques. So he observed the physical and the chemical behavior of the coordination compound by using some simple experimental techniques. So on the basis of this, Alfred Werner proposed, he proposed the concept of a primary valency. On the basis of this, he proposed the concept of the primary valency and the concept of the secondary valency for a metal ion. Primary valency and the secondary valency for a metal आयन. सो द बाइनरी कंपाउंड, फॉर एग्जाम्पल देयर इज अ बाइनरी कंपाउंड दैट सी आर सी एल थ्री. द बाइनरी कंपाउंड मीन्स विच इज मेड विद द हेल्प ऑफ टू डिफरेंट एलिमेंट. सो द बाइनरी कंपाउंड सच एज सी आर, दिस वन सी आर स्टैंड फॉर द क्रोमियम एंड दिस इज फॉर द क्लोरीन, एंड लाइक सी ओ सी एल टू, सी ओ स्टैंड फॉर द कोबाल्ट, सी एल इज फॉर द क्लोरीन. सो इट इज कंपोज ऑफ द टू डिफरेंट डिफरेंट एलिमेंट. सो बाइनरी कंपाउंड सच एज सी आर सी एल थ्री एंड सी ओ दैट इज सी ओ सी एल टू, दे हैव अ प्राइमरी वैलेंसी. दिस इट हैज अ प्राइमरी वैलेंसी ऑफ थ्री एंड इट हैज अ प्राइमरी वैलेंसी ऑफ टू. इट्स प्राइमरी वैलेंसी इज थ्री, दिस वन इज अ प्राइमरी वैलेंसी एंड इट्स प्राइमरी वैलेंसी इज इक्वल टू टू. सो इन इन अ सीरीज ऑफ अ कंपाउंड ऑफ कोबाल्ट, दिस इज कोबाल्ट, दिस इज कोबाल्ट, कोबाल्ट थर्ड क्लोराइड विद अमोनिया, वेन वी हैव सच टाइप ऑफ अ कंपाउंड. सो इट वॉज फाउंड दैट सम ऑफ द क्लोराइड आयन कुड बी प्रेसिपिटेटेड एज सिल्वर क्लोराइड. एंड वट इज द फॉर्मूला फॉर द सिल्वर क्लोराइड? दैट इज ए जी सी एल. दिस इज एज अ सिल्वर क्लोराइड ऑन एडिंग एक्सेस ऑफ सिल्वर नाइट्रेट सोल्यूशन. सो दैट इज AgNO3. AgNO3 stand for the silver nitrate and silver chloride is AgCl is the silver chloride and this one is the silver nitrate. This one is the silver nitrate solution. Solution in cold, but some remained in the solution. But some excess of when we if we mixes both. So but some particles are remain in the solution. So these observation together, and he has done the various type of a test with the cobalt third chloride and with the ammonia. That is the formula for the ammonia is NH3. NH3 stand for the ammonia. So these observation together with the result of conductivity measurement in solution can be explained. There are so many criteria to explain the primary valency, but later on we will discuss about the first of all. Actually, this theory is basically the theory given by the Werner is basically depend. It is for the structure. This theory is given for the structure, and it determine the physical and the chemical behavior by the simple experimental technique. Now, before starting the Werner's theory, because there are so many postulates for the Werner's theory of coordination compound, and in this theory we have studied about the primary valency. What are the primary valency? Here we have studied about the secondary valency, that how we can define the primary and the secondary valency. So this is the main concept of the Werner theory. Given by the Werner theory of coordination compound, and then now next I will we will discuss what is the primary valency, how we define the primary valency, how we define the secondary valency. Okay, now the next topic is primary valency. Primary valency. So primary valency are those which a metal exhibits, in the formation of its simple salt. So this is the one definition of the primary valency. But these days the primary valency is referred to as the oxidation state. is referred to as the oxidation state. So nowadays the oxidation state, the primary valency is termed as the oxidation state, but the definition for the primary valency is the primary valency is are those which a metal exhibit in the formation of its simple salt. And the next term in the Werner's theory is, that is secondary valency. So secondary valency are those which a metal atom, which a metal atom or cation form towards neutral molecule, or negative group. And the negative group is also known as the ligands. The negative group is also known as the ligand in the formation of complex ion. So the secondary valency is also termed as the coordination number. The secondary valency is also termed as the coordination number. Secondary valency is also termed as a coordination number. So these are the two important terms. First one is the primary valency and the second is the secondary valency. So these are the two important terms in the Werner's theory of coordination compound. The first one, primary valency, which is also known as the oxidation state, and the second is the secondary valency, which a metal atom or cation form towards the neutral molecule or towards the negative group, and that negative group is also known as the ligand in the formation of complex ion. And nowadays the secondary valency is also termed as the coordination number. If we are talking about the coordination number, the number which are present nearby the central metal ion atom or the ion, that is known as the coordination number. So the coordination number, the meaning of the coordination number is same as that of the secondary valency, because both are used for the same term.